We now continue to follow that developing news about the attempted child abduction in Amherst over the weekend. The police chief speaking out on the investigation so far as the suspect pleads not guilty at his arraignment earlier today. And Western Mass News reporter Audrey Russo has more.
I talked to one neighbor who didn't want to speak on camera, but he told me he was surprised to see that something like this could happen in a neighborhood that's only one street over from the Amherst police station.
Waking up in the middle of the night, finding an individual in your home is scary enough.
According to Amherst police, that individual was Jimmy Lee Sanchez, a 35-year-old man believed to be homeless. Police Chief Scott Livingstone tells Western Mass News Sanchez broke into a Spring Street home early Saturday morning. Livingstone says Amherst police have had prior dealings with Sanchez, including at least one break-in. He says Sanchez is known to law enforcement elsewhere, too.
I know that he has had other arrests in neighboring towns as well.
Livingstone says he didn't suspect what the Spring Street family would tell police, that they had to wrestle their toddler from Sanchez's arms, which they were able to do before the suspect fled.
To have the individual try and leave with an infant child, a lot of kudos to the family involved in that.
Livingstone says the crime scene being right around the corner from the police station helped officers.
We were able to get canine officers involved relatively quickly. And even though we didn't locate the individual immediately, that preserved evidence that helped us in our investigation.
Sanchez was arrested early Sunday morning. In Eastern Hampshire District Court Monday, court officials say he pleaded not guilty to attempted kidnapping charges, as well as larceny and breaking and entering. Livingstone believes Sanchez acted alone and that it wasn't targeted.
It looks like it might have been just the luck of the draw with an unlocked door.
Sanchez was ordered to be held and his case continued in the courts until March 22nd. In Amherst, Audrey Russo, Western Mass News.